In this module, we will learn a few inspection commands that help us find information about ROS nodes running as a part of a ROS application. First and foremost, we set up the ROS environment by sourcing the workspace setup files. Then, we have several ways to proceed forward. In this module, we will learn three commands that help us find our way around. The first command is ROS node list. This command prints a list of all running ROS nodes on the terminal. The next command is rqt underscore graph, which provides a visual representation of the different nodes and the way they interact with each other. And finally, the command ROS node info node name. This command prints node-specific information on the terminal. We will now study each of these commands in further detail. As the name suggests, the first command, ROS node list, lists all actively running ROS nodes on the terminal. The information is displayed as a list of node names, and these names can be used to find further information about a specific node. Instead of displaying the list of running nodes on a terminal, we can also have a graphical representation of the same using rqt underscore graph command. This command generates a graphical representation of the various nodes that are running and also those that are interacting with each other via topics. Note that there could be a standalone node that does not interact with any other node, but this is not very common. In the generated graphical representation, nodes are represented within ellipses and the topics are represented within rectangles. Finally, the last command, which can be used to obtain additional information of a running ROS node, is ROS node info node name. This command prints node-specific information on the terminal, such as the topics that the node is interacting with and the Linux process identifier associated with the node. There is quite a lot of information that we see here. I assure you, we will revisit this again in a future module to understand the various sections of information that we see. For now, what is important to note is the information regarding the topic interaction is very useful in the context of this course, and hence, we will focus on that in the remaining modules. Particularly, we will learn that a node can publish to or write to a topic and subscribe to or read from a topic. So far, we focused on finding information regarding one of the fundamental entities in a ROS application, namely ROS nodes. Let us now turn our attention towards finding information about the topics that are being exchanged between actively running nodes. This will be the focus of the next module.